These Illustrator tips will make you feel like you've become fully Adobe enlightened. Oh, and we're also going to make this thing later. But let's start with this window right here, the Navigator window. You might be thinking to yourself, how is this little panel so helpful? Well, trust me, when it comes to large documents like this one right here, it's a true gem. Now I can scroll around my document via this panel as it shows my entire workspace as a sort of preview. Also, I can just click to a certain point, like maybe the last page on my document. It just makes workflows more intuitive and less stressful, especially on these larger documents. So yeah, the Navigator panel. Open it up and slap it to your sidebar, just like this. It will come in handy. Next, not one, but two pen tool hacks that are totally going to change the way you use the pen tool. So when we want to make an awkward shape in Illustrator, maybe a logo mark, some custom typography or something like that, the best thing to do, the best practice, is to apply some guides. The guides are taken from the rulers on the edges of your document, and you should apply them whenever your shape or your artwork will touch a vertical or horizontal plane. So we want to drag out some handles carefully, and you can hold down shift to keep them straight. And then you simply just move to the next point of touch on your shape. Again, click and pull out some handles, but we can actually hold down the command or the control key and then manipulate the handles like so. And you can also hold down shift to keep them level, as I said before. That's the first hack with the pen tool. So I'm going to continue as we started, and I'm going to continue this vector path around the shape. But wait, what if I want to add anchor points while I'm still using the pen tool? Well, press shift and C on your keyboard, and then you can do things like this. Pretty neat little function, but once you're finished, you just simply press P for the pen tool again and continue with your path. And then here we finally have our neat and our smooth shape. Lovely. Now I'm going to hit you with three quick hotkeys that you likely won't know about, or at least you probably haven't used all three. The first one is with the type tool. Now if we want to click away from our text after we finished writing it out, we normally would have to come up to the selection tool, which is across to the other end of the screen, and you know it's just really annoying when you do it over and over again in a workflow. So instead, simply press the escape key on your keyboard and bingo, we now have the selection tool ready to use. The second hotkey is all about the EyeDropper tool, which is eye on your keyboard. That's not the trick. The trick is that, say if I wanted to take this CTA call to action here and I want to use a color sample from the gradient, if I do that, I will actually sample the entire gradient, which is annoying because I don't want that. Instead, hold down shift and then sample your color. And now you're actually going to sample a precise color. Sure, the CTA looked better before in blue, but this is just a demonstration. Now you can also click and hold down that click with the EyeDropper tool and actually move away from Illustrator to the edge of the screen somewhere else, and you can sample colors like this. But you often get false colors doing this, but it's also something pretty cool to know. Now here's a quick hack for aligning things in Illustrator. If I want to make a shape directly in the center, just find the center point and then hold down both Alt Option and Shift and click and drag. Now the shape is perfectly in the middle without using any alignment tools or features. We can also use this technique to generate shapes within other objects or shapes, but directly in the center. And then hopping into outline mode, which is Y on your keyboard, we can see that yes, in fact, they are super central. Now, it's time to put some of those things into practice and make this right here. Now, I saw this on Pinterest by a dude called Branding Expert, so appreciation to that guy. However, I did tweak the workflow a tiny bit myself and made it a bit more intuitive. So, draw out a circle with no fill and only a stroke using the Alt Option and Shift process. Then, press A for the Direct Selection tool and click the bottom half of your circle and then just delete it. Then press T and hover your cursor over the line until it says Path and then click. To make this perfect, get the Direct Selection tool and carefully move the text fully around on each side. Add your text and then open up the character window and increase the weight until we have maxed out the text on the line. Using the Selection tool, hold down the Alt Option key and then click and drag to duplicate. Then click here, hold down Shift and rotate 180 degrees. Perfect. Now I'm going to press I for the eyedropper tool and sample the background color. And don't worry, it hasn't disappeared. Select a different color and then generate a circle like so. We need to move this thing back and then bring it forward one layer so it's actually behind the text. I'm gonna bring the circle to about this size so it creeps over the text and then flick it over to a stroke and increase that stroke weight. In my experience, the closer to the edges the text is, the better. Now, select everything and press Command or Control G to group them together and then hill up the transform window found here. You can experiment with these values, but 80% here, then minus 19 right here, and at the bottom, 10 copies, and then click preview. Pretty cool looking, and like I said, you can actually experiment with values in this window, but we're not actually done yet. There's something important left to do. So select everything, then expand appearance, and then again, expand. Now you have individual objects that you can play around with and scale with ease. And I think this looks really cool actually. So props again to Branding Expert. A lot of resources used in today's video were actually sourced directly from Envato Elements. And it's something I personally use on a daily basis just to save time in my workflows. On Envato, there are millions of resources that designers can use on their projects. And lately, I've been grabbing a bunch of resources from the 3D section. You can even just click and rotate and choose the kind of point of view you want to download, which is pretty neat. There are tons of downloads though, and for all kinds of different projects and styles, and you can be confident using them on your designs because it's a one license fits all kind of deal when you sign up to Envato. Now you can try it for 7 days totally for free, but if you don't like it after that, you can just move on with your day as usual. And you can find Envato Elements linked in the description box below. But if you want to further boost your Adobe Illustrator workflow, just click the video on screen. And until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.